What is up, everyone? Andy with the Heartland Institute, bringing you more from climaterealism.com. So, everyone knows the polar bear is the face of climate alarmism. It always has been. The cute, cuddly polar bear. They can only call it cute and cuddly, by the way, because we're nowhere near them. If we were near polar bears and we saw videos of like what they can do, I don't think they'd be very cute and cuddly anymore. But the number two animal, which is also a face of climate alarmism, is the pika. Now, it is cute and cuddly. Check these out. Pikas are small, mountain-dwelling mammals found in Asia and North America. They have short limbs, very round bodies, and an even coat of fur, and no external tail. Now, during the past decade, pikas have become a bit of a poster child, I'd say, for climate alarmism. The reasoning is they're very warm-blooded, so if it becomes too warm, they'll overheat dangerously and die out and go extinct. Now, numerous websites and news sources have been putting articles out that make this case. Here's one here from the Huffington Post. Now, this Huffington Post article is interesting because it makes claims and calls for government action which is not needed. Let's read a bit from it here. The author writes, "The evidence seems unequivocal. The American pika is rapidly vanishing from the mountains of the western U.S., and scientists say it is climate change that has imperiled these tiny mammals." Yet, the Fish and Wildlife Service last month denied the pika protections under the Endangered Species Act, even though it has gone extinct locally in many areas of the West. Conservationists say politics rather than science drove the decision, which they called an enormous disappointment. And then later in the article, they have someone say this. "It's devastating that they are disappearing from so many of the places where we used to see them. By extinguishing these beautiful creatures, we are creating a lonelier planet." Alright, so that reads a lot like many of the alarmist articles I've read over the years. We have this cute, cuddly, adorable animal, this time the pika. It's going extinct in local regions. We need government action to save it. It's going to devastate the world. Well, how could we live without pikas? And I'm not saying I want a world without pikas. Those things are freaking adorable. I want the pika. Now, I know the lady that said the world's getting lonelier in the Huffington Post article is very compelling, very scientific evidence. I mean, don't get me wrong, I don't want to push back on proper science like that. But let's look at something a little bit better. So, we're going to look at Andrew Smith, a pika expert and a professor emeritus at Arizona State University. In 2017, Smith writes, "I worked with state and federal officials on a study that identified 3,250 site records of pika habitat." So, he's someone that actually works with these animals. Here's what he finds. So what we're looking at here is the website The Conversation. It's a liberal news site, but it's got an article by Andrew Smith that says pikas aren't going extinct. Here's what he says. "Pikas are adapting to climate change remarkably well, contrary to many predictions." Smith also writes, "When fellow hikers see me observing pikas in California, Sierra Nevada, they often tell me they have read that these animals are going extinct," notes Smith. "I've collected a stack of press releases that say exactly that. But based on my recent research and comprehensive review of over 100 peer-reviewed studies, I believe that this interpretation is misleading." Smith also says, "Based on my review of dozens of studies, pika populations appear to be secure in their core range, the mountains of western North America that have large and fairly well-connected talus habitat." So the final thing that we're going to read from Smith here relates very well to arguments that alarmists make frequently. So check it out. "The fact that pikas have also adapted to a number of marginal hot environments suggests to me that they are more resilient to climate change than many past studies have concluded. Most species exhibit losses near the edge of their geographical ranges simply because individual animals in those zones are living in conditions that are less than ideal for them. This does not mean they are going extinct." So essentially what Smith is saying is that, yes, there may be small regions in the United States where pikas aren't doing well, and that's what Huffington Post referenced. They say, oh, we're finding them dying out in these small areas. But what's important here is that in their core habitats, in the habitats that are actually suitable for pikas, they are resilient to climate change. They're not suddenly going extinct, and they shouldn't be the poster child for climate alarmism. Now, the Huffington Post did reference these small regions, but that's why they did it. They're like, well, we can't talk about the core regions for pika habitats because they're fine there. So let's talk about small areas where they shouldn't be and say, oh, they're dying, and then put in some pictures of pika. The article is filled with pictures of pikas, and again, they are adorable. And then talk about some woman who says the world's becoming lonelier. It's an emotional argument. It's not a factual one. It's not a logical one. And the reason they do that is because emotional arguments are effective. When you look at this article that has an adorable little animal, I know I say adorable a lot, but I really want to get across how you know, cuddly these things are. But yeah, when you put an article out that shows this cute little animal and then you say they're dying out and we're going to lose one of the cutest animals on Earth, people will have an emotional connection to that. They'll post it on Facebook, they'll post it on Twitter, and the photo, the thumbnail, will end up being the animal. And people say, no, we can't lose those. But if you actually put out scientific evidence that says, yeah, outside of their core habitat, they may be struggling, they're doing fine in their core habitat, and you put a graph up, it's not going to do as well. People aren't going to retweet it. They're not going to blast it out on Facebook. So that's how many alarmist websites like the Huffington Post will get clicks and will spread news that is not entirely factual. The real news, which comes from Andrew Smith, the Pika expert, doesn't get up as high, but it's what you really want to read. So I just wanted to talk about the Pika today, and again, the adorable little animal, talking about how they're doing fine. I'm going to put a picture of them up one more time because they're awesome, and peace. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel and consider donating to the Heartland Institute to support more vibrant free markets, greater individual liberties, and more videos like this one.